Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here. It's Monday, June 2nd, 2014, and we're coming up to 8 a.m. on the East Coast. And stock index futures are flat this morning, so we're looking for a quiet open at 9:30 Monday morning. Now, one of the reasons things might be quiet this morning is that the Apple Developers Conference is getting started today, and it's a multi-day event. So there's lots of opportunity for Apple to release news over the next couple of days, and also for third-party developers to release news. Now, we've had a really nice move in Apple, and you may remember that I talked about taking profits and taking some money off the table back here. And of course, we always talk about not completely liquidating a position. So if you did lock in some profits here, the market has continued to move higher. And on Monday, we're looking for a close below 607.79. So the market's going to be looking to see if this is another situation of buy the rumor, sell the news, or if Apple comes out with something very exciting that nobody anticipated, that could certainly push the stock up higher. This is a weekly price target chart, so right now we're clustering around the 625 level. We closed above that on Friday, so we don't have a complete breakaway from that 625 level. The bar traded through it. And so if we continue to move higher, then 687.50 would be our next target to the upside for Apple. Next up, let's take a look at some monthly charts, starting with the VIX. The VIX was down nearly 15% on the month. And of course, that is supportive for higher stock prices. Bonds moved up last month, up over 3%, now back on a monthly buy signal. The Japanese yen, fairly quiet trading there, up slightly last month. When the Japanese yen does start to trend again, that will have a dramatic effect on the stock market. Looking at the stock market, the Dow was up nearly 1%, S&P 500 up over just over 2%, and then more strength in big cap tech stocks with the NASDAQ up 4.32%. But then when you move away from the big cap stocks, you get to the mid caps, and then the small micro caps, the gains start to drop off dramatically. So the Russell was up 0.68%. The ZAX micro cap was only up 0.11% on the month, trading in the channel. So we're seeing some weakness in small and micro cap stocks in the U.S. North of the border, the TSX, which is trading above the 2010 high, but has not broken out above the 2008 high, was down on the month 0.33%. That had a lot to do with a weakness in mining stocks. The Venture Exchange was down 1.75%. And of course, that has a lot to do with anything to do with the gold miners, and gold miners down nearly 8%, 7.8% on the XAU, 7.53% on the TSX Gold Index. So we did have some strength a couple months ago, took us through the upper channel line, but could not hold those gains. And so here we are, we're not that far away from the 2008 lows. So the market might have to take us down to that point, but I would certainly want to buy any buy signals that come up here in the gold sector. Looking at gold itself, it was down 3.86% for the month of May, still on a monthly sell signal. And looking at crude oil, up nearly 3%, still trying to break out of above these previous highs here, up at the $110 level for the price of crude oil. Next up, let's drill down and take a look at some 60-minute charts, starting with the VIX. The VIX is right down at the bottom of the panic zone, new pressure zone starting to form. We're overdue for a pop in the VIX, and I talked about buying the VIX last week, and I bought a partial position. I'm going to add to it this week as well. And when and if the VIX breaks out above the 200-hour moving average, that will certainly cause people's heads to turn. And that right now is around 1275, 1280, and continuing to decline. The first sign of any change on Monday is going to be an hourly close above 1161 for the VIX. Looking at the S&P 500 cash index, we're currently clustering right around resistance at 1921. And change, if we start moving higher on Monday, then 1929.69 is our next target, and then 1937.50. On the downside, first sign of a change on Monday is going to be an hourly close below 1917.15. For the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for a move up to 37.50. That's our next target to the upside on both the hourly, daily, weekly charts. And looking down, we need an hourly close below 37.2485 on Monday to give us a new intraday sell signal. Looking at the XAU, we put in a double bottom last week, and then we came up, and on Friday we came right back up to those highs that we had made a couple of days ago, right into an open gap. And so we're looking to see if we can break above that today. If we can, then look for a move above 88. You can see that there's an open gap there, and that would take us above the top of our flypaper channel. And so that would start to get people's attention if we could do that. Looking at the TSX, we put in a higher low last week, started to move up. TSX looks very much like the XAU. Look two lines up, and a move up to 14,687.50 would be a reasonable target to the upside for the TSX. On the downside on Monday, an hourly close below 14,556 would generate a new intraday sell signal for the TSX. Next up, we're looking at commodity ETFs, starting with crude oil. Crude oil traded down to the lower channel line on Friday. A close below Friday's low, below 37.53, would give us a sell signal on Monday. A close below 60.72 for gasoline and 24.63 would give us sell signals for gasoline and natural gas. Looking at copper, we're back on a sell signal as of Friday's close. A close above 38.53 would give us a buy signal on Monday, not expecting to see that. Gold, platinum, and silver all continued to move lower on Friday. Next up, we're looking at stocks, bonds, and currencies, and the VIX continued to move lower on Friday. A daily close above 12.38 would certainly get people's attentions this week. Bonds pulled back on Friday, but still trading above the upper channel line. Very quiet trading for currencies on Friday, with the Japanese yen having an inside day. Looking at stocks, the S&P 500 continued to move higher on Friday. We were looking at the hourly charts earlier. Two lines up on the hourly charts takes us up to 19.3750. That's our next daily target to the upside. Looking north of the border, the TSX had an inside day on Friday, so no change there. So a close on Monday below 14,588.61 would give us a new sell signal for the TSX on Monday. Okay, folks, that's all for Monday morning. Looking over my shoulder, futures are still very quiet, and so I think the first thing we may see the market respond to this week is news out of the Apple Developers Conference. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again soon.